Hello YouTube. Today is kind of chilly outside. And so I'm wearing lots of layers, and I thought today might be a good time to make a video of getting dressed. Like, obviously, you know, I can put my shirt on just fine, although my fingers are getting numb. But, you know, I survive. Okay, so, and I have my tights and my diaper on already. I am wearing a diaper because I'm going to be going and running some errands and stuff. And so I just want to make sure, because you never know when you'll be able to find a restroom. Now, next up is leggings. So this is like what I do to get my pants and leggings or whatever. Like, I try to just hook my foot. Sometimes I do it when the foot is still down by the footrest. Then I'll hook my foot on. And then once I get the left leg in, that's my hardest leg. So once that gets in, then I'm pretty much okay. Now, on the feet, I'll pull back a little bit. Like, okay, I am trying not to pull. Oh man, I already did it. I was trying to keep it down, like, on my heel, so that it'll be easier when I put my knee highs on. It'll hold the leggings down, but I don't know if that's gonna stay. But we'll try. We'll try it. See what happens. Okay, so my right leg is a lot easier. It is, you know, much easier to manipulate. And because it's more atrophied, because that's the leg that I first, that's the one I broke my right hip on. That is the leg that when the numbness first started spreading down my butt, then, it affected, like, my right leg. It was my right butt cheek, then my left butt cheek. And then it was my right thigh, and then my left thigh, and then it slowly spread down my legs. But it's always started with the right first. Okay, so now, it's not gonna work with these leggings. All right, I'll just let them go up. Okay, so now to pull, so once my pants are like about thigh level, then I'm gonna just straighten up the seam here. Then I typically, like, you know, try to get them up as high as possible before I use my forearm and kind of, you know, lift the pants up around my butt. Oh man, do you know what I forgot? I'm going to work out while I'm rolling around town today. So, I'm going to put my my EMS on my body so I can be getting buff while I roll around town. Okay, so the leggings still, like, are kind of down, but they're pretty much up. I just, you know, I like them to be up a little bit more. Okay, that'll work. That'll work. Alright, so those are leggings. Now, a lot of times if I'm wearing a skirt like I am today, then a lot of times I'll just put the skirt on over my head because it's easier, and then I'll just kind of, you know, pull it down around my butt later. So, also, this is just a side note, but, as you know, I have little boobs and stuff. Just saying, I went to Walmart and I bought, bras, because I haven't bought bras in a really long time. And since my boobs are little, then I was able to get bras in the kids section, and they're so much cheaper. So, hey, if you have little boobs and you're looking for cheap bras, check out the kids section, because seriously, you could get, I got like 3 for $10, and usually real bras are like $10 or more for one bra. Plus, the cool thing about the kid bras, they don't have underwires like some of them do, but anyway, you know, underwires are annoying too. So, that's a nice thing. I wear kid leggings too. They're usually the size 10 to 12 in the kids fits me the best for my leggings and stuff. I have size 10 jeggings, but they're actually, I think, too tight, and they don't feel very comfortable. Okay, so now trying to find my skirt so I can pull it under my butt. Part of any outfit for me is what? The socks, of course. So, next up, socks. Once I get my skirt. Okay, so that's the bad thing with putting it over your head. It's kind of like bunched up, but I think I got it now. I got it! Woohoo! Okay, so now, socks, because today I'm dressing up like it's fun. I had a friend, my friend said, you should dress up like China, you know, or something, like a Chinese person, and I didn't really have anything. So we decided on eggs instead, because they make like egg drop soup and, you know, fried egg rolls and stuff. It doesn't really matter which leg I put them on first. So sometimes, you know, if my left leg has been incredibly difficult, then sometimes I'll choose to put that one on first, just because, you know. Well, actually, no, probably not. If my left leg is being really difficult, then I probably wouldn't put. I would just wait until maybe it calms down, and then later I can more easily put it on. Come on, socks. It's weird putting socks on over tights and stuff, but it will help keep my toes warm, since as you know, I hate shoes. Okay, so now these leggings don't really, oh, you know what? I got some different leggings, but I don't know what I did with them. Anyway, oh, you know what? Another thing that sometimes I do when I'm getting dressed, is to, put my seatbelt on. Because, there's nothing worse than falling out of your chair. I mean, there are worse things, but, I don't like to fall out of my chair. So, sometimes I buckle up before it happens. The other day, I didn't know I was messing with my mustache smile, and I forgot to buckle up, and I was leaning too far over, and, you know, next thing I knew, I was on the floor, but rode the footrest to the couch, got back on the couch, and then think I just hung out on the couch for a while instead of getting back into my chair right away. Okay. One sock down. It looks kind of short, but it'll work. And then another sock. Now sometimes, when I put coats on, like I'm going to today, well, I'll show you that in a little bit. In the meantime, now this, here goes the difficult leg. Here it goes. Come on, you can do it. So, okay. I can start my toes. That's the most important thing. Then I'm good. And I just need to pull this up. I'm not ready for you to drop yet. I gotta get this sock over my heel and then it can drop. Like, I mean, technically, I guess it could have dropped before then and I would have still been able to get the sock on since my toes were already in. But, it's easier if I at least get the heel, all on my foot before I let go down. Okay, so now back up a little bit just so you can see even more. Okay, now I'm going to try to get my socks up over the leggings without getting the leggings too like bunched up or whatever. Sometimes, if I have leggings like this and they don't, like if it gets bunched up when I put my knee highs on, then sometimes I just reach into the legging and try to kind of smooth it out. But I think it's probably good enough. This video and show you one more thing. Okay, this, when I put coats on, it depends. Sometimes, like, my backrest on my wheelchair protects my back from the cold a lot and from the wind and stuff, so sometimes I wear coats backward. Sometimes I'll just wear them like this. You know, if it's really cold outside, then it's like a blanket, you know, and so it keeps my front all warm. But today, I'll probably, flip it around and wear it regularly. You know, this is my eggshell for the egg today. Okay, but anyway, I'm not gonna put my jacket on yet because I'm not ready to go outside. I still gotta brush my teeth. And, maybe I'll put some makeup on, but doubt it. But I gotta get my hat. The hat I want to wear is breaking, and And so I'm debating on whether I should try to fix it real quick or just let it go. Or, like, I'm gonna fix it at some point, but I could wear a different hat. I don't technically have to wear the broken one. But I really like that one, and so I think I probably will fix it and wear it. But in the meantime, that's it. Now you know how I get dressed. Alright. Hi, YouTube. I hope you guys are all doing awesome today. Whoops.